It's Catherine, and welcome to today's 10-minute masterclass, which is all about starting before you're ready. I run personal development programs that help women get clarity and confidence and traction towards their big life goals. And I'm running a series of masterclasses, short little videos in 10 minutes or less, where I'm dealing with topics that women typically find a bit tricky or challenging. So the topic today, as I say, is start before you're ready. And this is such an important thing. This is a really big one. So I'm running a program at the moment, and some ladies in my program are thinking about putting themselves in a position where they can get a promotion at work. And one of the questions that I asked them recently was, what would you do differently when, what will you do differently when you get your promotion? And their answers were really interesting. So their answers were things like, I would dress differently, I would walk differently, and I would have the confidence to put forward more ideas. I would have the confidence to come up with new ways of doing things and encourage people to try new things that I think would work better. So then what we talked about was how important it is to start doing these things even before you get the promotion that you want. So I read a quote once that stuck with me that I really liked, and it said, dress for the job you want and not for the job you have. So if you think that whenever you're doing a better job, you will dress differently, you make it more likely that you're going to find that better job if you start dressing for it today. And maybe that means dressing more confidently, wearing brighter colors, getting out of your kind of work uniform. I don't know if you have one of these. I do. Whenever I'm in a bit of a work rut, I have a pair of black trousers and a top that I will just wear all the time. And the black trousers are very much the default. And then when I realize that I've been wearing my black trousers too much, I realize that I'm in a bit of a rut and I need to shake things up a little bit. So I'll wear a dress, and then that will make me feel a little bit different. So do you ever get stuck in a bit of a work rut clothes-wise? And if so, is there something that you can do about that to help yourself progress? The other point about putting forward ideas and having the confidence to talk about new ways of doing things is a really big one, and I totally understand that. So sometimes whenever we think about where we'd like to get to, we think, when I get there, I'm going to be a totally different person. I'm going to feel more confident. I'm going to look more confident. Everyone's going to really love me. Everyone's going to respect me. Everyone's going to think I'm really great. So that's going to create a really brilliant environment for me to be my best self. Then sometimes when you find yourself in promoted situations, you realize, I still feel a bit scared. I still feel a bit nervous. I don't know if people like me. I don't know what they're going to think of this idea. So you are still yourself. You're still the same person. So how do we get around this? So I think one of the most important things to remember is that you can feel scared about things and do them anyway. You don't need to wait until you're not scared, not nervous, not anxious. It's fine to feel anxious and crack on with the things that you want to do. But the second and probably more important thing is you need to start doing those things today, because that's going to help you move more quickly towards your goal. So if you have ideas, then talk your ideas through with people. If you have suggestions about how to do things better, put those suggestions out there. Now, I would suggest doing this in quite a strategic way. So you don't want to come across as having, you know, too much going on and just to be kind of throwing all of these ideas out there in kind of a random way. So if you can, make it strategic. So take a step back and think about the ideas that you've had and ask yourself whether you can categorize those ideas in a particular way strategically. So for example, you might think that you can improve the way your team works by making new connections out in the sector. You might think your team can work better by working more productively or efficiently in the way it goes about doing the things that it's doing already. You might think that your team could work better if you could perhaps move into a new area, identify new opportunities. So these are all things that can help you grow and become more efficient in the way that you do your work. So as you think through your ideas, think about whether there are themes, and perhaps sit down with your line manager and have a conversation about one or two of those themes. So for example, you could say in perhaps a one-to-one meeting, you know, I've been thinking about whether we could do our work more efficiently, and I have a few ideas about ways of working that would make us more efficient. These ideas are things like, then you give your examples, and then you could ask your line manager, so what do you think about that? Do you think these are ideas that would be useful to explore? And then you can have that introductory conversation where you have something thematic, and then your ideas. That makes it feel structured and gives your line manager, your boss, confidence that you're thinking things through strategically. And then I bet they'd say yes. As I was saying to one of my ladies in my programme, I have managed teams of varying sizes, up to about 50 people. And I have never had a situation where someone's come to me with an idea for doing things better, where I thought, I really wish this person wouldn't bring ideas like this to me. I always want to hear new ideas. As a manager, I always want to be doing the best job I can. I want my team to be doing the best job they can. And so I'm always really, really delighted to hear ideas about how we can do things better. So why don't you have a think about what you would do differently if you were promoted into the role that you'd like to move into next? Write those things down, do a little list, and then have a think about whether there are some of those things that you can start doing today. It gives people around you confidence that you're ready to move on to the next stage in your career, and it gives you confidence to try out new things in an environment where you're not under a lot of pressure to perform at that higher level, because you're at your current level, and so you have a little bit of space and a little bit of opportunity to try some things and see how it feels and see how they work. So that's all for today's 10 minute masterclass. If you find this helpful, I'd love it if you could let me know in the comments, tag a friend who would like to hear this as well. And if there's anything in particular that you'd like me to cover in a future 10 minute masterclass, then just drop me a line. I'll speak to you soon. Bye.